The first of the three prostate cancer predictors is a blood test called the PSA, or prostate-specific antigen test.
In the 1990s and now in the new millennium, routine PSA testing picks up most prostate cancers before they would ever be found on routine digital examinations.
The PSA test measures the level of an enzyme that's put out by the normal prostate gland. In a man under the age of 60, PSA in the blood should normally be less than 4. As a man gets older and his prostate gland gradually enlarges with age, that PSA may increase slightly. But where cancer is present, the PSA may go up suddenly, and this rise is an important predictor of the chance for the disease to spread. Patients who have a PSA greater than 20 are at a substantial risk that the cancer has already moved beyond the gland to other parts of the body. Patients with a PSA between 10 and 20 have a lower but still significant risk that the cancer has at least broken outside of the capsule of the gland. Those patients that have a PSA of less than 10 have only a small risk that the cancer has moved anyplace else. If your PSA is less than 4, your risk is even smaller.
If a person has a PSA that is above 4 but below 10, the elevation of the PSA is not necessarily due to cancer. It may be due to an enlarged prostate or due to inflammation of the prostate. A blood test called the PSA2, or free PSA, may be useful in these cases. PSA exists in the blood in at least two forms, one bound to certain proteins, one floating free. The PSA2 measures the amount of free PSA. If the level is less than 20% of the total PSA, there is a high suspicion that the overall PSA elevation is due to cancer. If the percentage free is 25% or above, there is less likelihood of cancer. 20 to 25% is still a gray area. This test may help in determining whether a patient with an elevated PSA needs a biopsy or not.
It's important to add here that many other things besides cancer can influence your PSA result, including sexual intercourse, the digital rectal examination, infections of the prostate, or any trauma to the rectum. So we always have to consider these factors first before drawing any conclusions about the significance of the PSA results. In addition to the absolute level of the PSA, the rate at which it is changing over time is very important. If a person's PSA doubles in less than 6 months, it is a sign of a very aggressive cancer. If it takes longer than 2 years to double, it is much less aggressive. The more PSA values that are available for review over a prolonged period of time prior to the diagnosis, the more helpful the PSA velocity information. PSA density refers to the idea that a large prostate makes more PSA than a small prostate. Taking into account the volume of the prostate can give a better understanding of the actual PSA level.
When test results reveal that a PSA is elevated and suspicious for cancer, the next step is to perform a biopsy. Today, biopsies are performed using a transrectal ultrasound.
A small ultrasound probe is inserted in the rectum, and a needle is inserted through that into the prostate. Usually, 14 to 20 pieces of tissue are removed, spaced throughout the entire gland.